la ilaha illallah.
Hayya shifa'u sudur.
La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Insha'Allah ta'ala, today we will be covering the practical method of wudu according to the Hanafi Fiqh, insha'Allah, in light of the Qur'an and Hadith. Wudu in itself is very essential, as without this one cannot perform many worships. For example, it is the key to prayer. Without having wudu, one cannot pray salah. Without having wudu, one cannot touch the Qur'an. Without having wudu, one cannot perform tawaf of the Kaaba, etc. So this is a very essential part of our faith. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that purity in itself is half of faith. So purity is half of faith. One of the methods of purifications that the Muslims utilize for their worships is wudu. So inshallah ta'ala, today we will be covering that part of purification. To begin with, the first sunnah of wudu is to make an intention. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Verily, actions are based upon intentions. Therefore, if a person does not intend to do wudu, then regardless of how many times he washes those limbs, he will not be rewarded for it. For example, if a person is showering, all the parts which are to be washed during wudu will also be washed whilst he's under that shower. Yet he will not be rewarded for wudu because he did not intend it. So in order to attain the virtues and the rewards of wudu, one must intend wudu so that he's rewarded for it. And also something to take into account is that before actually performing wudu, one should not only intend to purify his outer self, but he should also cleanse and purify his inner self. Now, if one was to call a king to his home and decorate the outside of his home, yet leave the inside filthy, would the king be pleased upon entering? Of course not. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not only look at your actions, rather He looks towards your hearts and your intentions. So it's very important to purify your heart as well as your outer limbs. The second sunnah of wudu is to recite the basmala, to recite the tasmiyah. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, لا وضوء لمن لم يسمى. There is no wudu for the one who does not recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now what this actually means is that he will be deprived of the blessings, nafyul fadila. He'll be deprived of the blessings, he'll be deprived of the extra virtues that he could attain by reciting Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in comparison to if he wasn't to recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. For the one who recites Bismillah, it would be as though his entire body is cleansed. Whereas if he does not recite Bismillah, only the limbs which he washed would be cleansed and purified. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he also said, كُلُّ ذِي أَمْرٍ بَالٍ لَمْ يُبْدَأْ بِبِسْمِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ أَقْطَأُ وَأَبْتَرُ. Every virtuous matter, every significant matter which is not begun with Bismillah, it is cut, it is severed, it is deficient, it is deprived of blessings. So the second sunnah is to recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And then the third sunnah, we come to know from the hadith of the Mawla, the slave of Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an. He says that he saw Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an da'a bi ina'in. He called for a utensil. فَأَفْرَغَ عَلَىٰ كَفَّيْهِ. There was water within the utensil, and he poured that water over his hands. فَغَسَلَهُمَا. And he washed them. ثَلَاثَ مِرَارٍ. He washed them thrice. Now, we have before us a tap, so the water is flowing, so there's no need for us to place our hand in a bucket and then flow water over our hands thrice. So because the water is flowing from the tap, it would be sufficient that I just wash my hands beneath it thrice and then close the tap. Just before I continue, it's very important to take into account that when using the water, try and use as less as possible. In the sense, do not try and use an excessive amount of water, because wasting water Is that permitted? So, and especially if one is performing wudu in a masjid, then it should be even more wary. So we do not want to waste water. Just have a sufficient amount of water which will purify the limb. And note down that it is essential for 2 drops of water to flow on every part of that limb for it to be considered washed. So inshaAllah ta'ala, I will now wash my hands. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now this is sufficient. Washing thrice, this is sufficient. And then also an individual, if he likes, he can do khilal. Then the next step of wudu is that this mawla of Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, he says, ثُمَّ أَدْخَلَ يَمِينَهُ فِي الْإِنَى. Then Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, he placed his right hand within the bucket of water, within the utensil of water, فَمَضْمَضَ, and he rinsed his mouth. Now alongside the rinsing of the mouth, one can also gargle. So again, we do not want to waste water. As soon as you have a handful of water, place it into your mouth, closing the tap so the water is not wasted. And gargling in itself is also an additional sunnah. So as such. This Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala and then thrice, I'm only performing it once, as once is also sufficient, but the sunnah is to do it thrice, even though the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam at times would wash the limbs only once to show that it is permissible. But in order to act upon the sunnah, one should do it thrice. Thereafter, wastanshaqa, he rinsed his nose. He cleansed his nose. So again, just taking a portion of water into the hand, sniffing up the nose, blowing it out, and not wasting water. Then one may use his little finger to cleanse his nose, as such, of his left hand. Then the next step of the wudu is an obligation, which is to wash the face. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala highlights the fara'id in the Quran when he says, فَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ وَامْسَهُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ. To wash the face is an obligation, and the second obligation which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala highlights in the Quran is to wash the hands up till and including the elbows. And the third obligation is a mas' of the head, wiping of the head. And the fourth obligation is to wash both feet, including the ankles. Now, within the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions wiping the head, but the amount is not mentioned. This is something we refer to as mujmal. So now we need bayan, we need elaboration, we need further detail in relation to how much is actually fard. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we come to find within a hadith that ata subatata qawmin, he came to a dump site of a nation, fabala, then he urinated, wa tawadda'a, he performed wudu, wa masaha ala nasiyatihi, and he wiped upon a nasiya of the head. Now Sahih Bukhari, he mentions that a nasiya is rub'ur ra's. How much is nasiya? It's a quarter of the head. So wiping a quarter of the head is an obligation in the Hanafi Fiqh. So the next step that we are going to take is to wash the face. If a person fulfills the obligations and misses out the sunnah, his wudu will still be done. However, if he makes a habit of missing his sunnah, he will be sinful. So it should not be a habit of an individual to miss out his sunnah unless he is lacking time, etc. The next step is washing the face. How much is considered the face? From where the hairline begins till below the chin, and from one ear to the next, this entire area is referred to as the face. Now for those who have beards, thick beards, they should make sure that the water reaches the roots of the hair, and for those who have a thin beard should make sure that the water actually reaches the surface of the skin. So once again, we do not want to waste water. Now as you can see, I've only washed a part of my face, not the entire face. I've not yet included the skin beneath the beard, and I'm not also included. And this is something to be very cautious about. Many people with beards, they may miss out this area in between the beard and the ear. This is also a fard to wash. So this is important that it is also washed. So be cautious when washing the face. Again, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam would wash his face thrice. Now when washing the beard, one may take water within his hands, within the palm of his hands, and rub on his beard. Or if he finds it easier, he may just place his beard near the tap and wash his face as such. To make sure that that entire surface is washed. Or like I mentioned, he may just take piles of water and rub on each side, making sure the water actually reaches the entire skin. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam would do this thrice, thalatha marrat. But I am only washing once, as I mentioned, I am beneath flowing water. So I can take water thrice and wash my face thrice, but I let the water flow through my beard, so it was sufficient that I don't do that thrice. The next step in wudu is the second obligation, which is to wash both arms. Now, whilst rinsing the mouth, I did not perform the miswak. This is also a sunnah. I do not have the miswak with me at present. So inshallah ta'ala, I will explain that within another video. As for now, the next step after wudu is to wash both arms up to and including the elbows. So one must make sure that the folds within the skin, such as this area, is also washed. Sometimes people pull up their sleeves and they only pull it up, they only pull it up to a certain extent, maybe around this area or just even on the bone of the elbow, which would mean that they would not include the full elbow upon washing. So they would be missing out on obligation and their wudu will not be valid. So we must make sure that the entire arm is washed. And it's also a habit of people to flow water over the arm as such. And in this case, as I mentioned earlier, 2 drops of water to flow upon each part of that limb is an obligation. So 1 drop of water would flow here, 1 drop of water would flow here, 1 drop of water would flow here when a person is just raising his arm, and he may miss out, and in most cases he does miss out the obligation of washing the entire arm. Or if he has already washed the entire arm, then there's no need for this, as this is just wasting water. The Mawla of Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after the rinsing of the nose, he mentions ثُمَّ غَسَلَ وَجْهَهُ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتِ. He washed his face thrice. وَيَدَيْهِ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتِ. And he washed his hands إِلَى الْمِرْفَقَيْنِ, up to and including the elbows thrice. Now because I have flowing water, there's no need for me to flow my arms through it thrice. So it would be sufficient for me to just twist my arm as such, as I am under flowing water, and wash my entire arm. And I do likewise with the second arm. So one must wash from the very fingertips up unto and including the elbows. Then the next step of wudu, Sayyiduna Uthman radiallahu ta'ala upon performing wudu, he wiped his head. وَمَسَهَا بِرَأْسِهِ. He wiped his head. Now, as I mentioned earlier, wiping a quarter of the head is an obligation. But the sunnah method is to wipe the complete head, what the Malikiyah consider an obligation. It is a sunnah for us to wipe the complete head. So just take some water into the hand. There's no need to wash. This is wiping of the head. Have these 3 fingers separated as such, and the index finger and the thumb will also be separated. Now with these 3 fingers, we'll begin from where the hairline begins, and we will rub all the way back, wipe all the way back till the back side of our head, and then we will pull forward with the palms of our hand on the sides, and then we can use the index finger to cleanse the inner section of the ear, and the thumb to cleanse the outer section of the ear. Now the final action in wudu which is also the final obligation, is to wash both feet up to and including the ankles. It's very important that you make sure that the heels are washed and also the parts in between the toes, they are also cleansed and washed. At times people miss this out. At times people would open the tap, they open the tap and they just give a little rub with their feet, and not every part of their foot is actually washed, so they would be missing out on obligation. So it's very important that the entire foot is cleansed as such. Again, making sure that the heels are purified, and that fold beneath the toes should also be purified. One may then also perform khilal if he wishes to do so. Again, with the second foot. And there you have it. That is the complete method of wudu according to the Hanafi Fiqh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to act in accordance to that. There are additional things which a person may say and also do within the wudu. However, this video was just restricted to the sunan and the fara'id of wudu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to benefit from this video. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to perform wudu for our salah and pray our five daily salahs on time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
La ilaha illallah.